Good morning, dear students. I am Jyoti Prabha Nahak, and in our previous session, we have discussed about countables. Mainly, we there discuss the different countable nouns and how we can make the singular countable nouns into a plural form. And today, we will learn about uncountables. So, let's go to the smart board and start our topic. So, dear students, what is uncountable? Today we will discuss uncountable. So, what is uncountable? The noun which we can't count, we cannot count, that is called uncountable. So, let's see some criteria of uncountable nouns. So, what are the criteria? First one is, we do not use a or an, several, a few, or numerals like 1, 2, etc. before uncountable nouns. So, we cannot use a or an, several, a an, several, a few, or numerals like 1, 2. We cannot use before or an uncountable noun. Then, uncountables mostly go with singular verbs. Always the uncountable noun have their singular verb. Then number three, we can use the, this, that, some, a lot of, enough, a little before uncountable noun. So we may or we can add such type of word, the, this, that, some, a lot of, enough, a little before an uncountable noun. Okay, so let's see how we can use different words, the, that, this, before uncountable, with the example of milk. Then, I do not like milk. Here, milk is uncountable, and here, milk is general. It is used in general. Then, where is the milk I kept here? Here, the is used before the uncountable noun, milk. And here the means the specific milk. It's specific reference. Specify kara jai chi. The lage ke milk ko specify kara jai chi. Then, this is my milk, but that is yours. My. Before the uncountable noun milk, we use your my. So, it means possessive. To possess someone. Okay. Then, next. Please boil this or that milk. This or that milk. Then you will find here some, a lot of, enough, a little, no, such type of words are used before uncountable noun. Then there is not much any milk left. So before uncountable, milk is here uncountable, and we use different words such as the, my, then this, that, some, a little, enough, a lot of, no. So, such type words, much, any, such type of words we can use before uncountable nouns. There are some nouns which are, there are some uncountable nouns which are ending in S. The nouns ending in S, usually they look like plural, but actually they are uncountables and they always go with a singular verb form. For examples, diseases, the name of the diseases, measles, mumps, rabies, itches, such type of diseases, although the name of the diseases end in S letter, S consonant, it looks like plural, but this is uncountable and these are always go with singular verb form. Then also subject of study, for example, physics, statistics, economics, politics, electronics, such type of subject of study, subjects are also ending in S and they are uncountables and they always go with singular verb form. Then sports activities, athletics, sports, cars, billiards. Such type of sports activities are also ending in S and they are also uncountables and they also go with singular verb form. will say quantifying the uncountable. So what is quantifying units? What is quantifying nouns? To make an uncountable noun as countable, we have to add some phrases or some quantifying nouns, such as your, if we take the word tea, here tea is uncountable, and if we want to make tea countable, then we have to add a cup of tea. So here a cup of is quantifying unit. Coffee, a cup of coffee. Chocolate, a bar of chocolate. Ice cream, a piece of ice cream. Milk, a glass of milk. Ice, a block of ice. Soap, a bar of soap. Advice, a piece of advice. Paper, a sheet of paper. So we can add different quantifying nouns to make an uncountable as countable. Okay, so today we came to know that uncountables, which are the nouns which we cannot count, and they always go with singular verb forms. There are also some nouns which are ending in s. They looks like plural, but actually they are uncountables, and they always go with singular verb forms. And if we want to make an uncountable as countable, then we have to add quantifying units to make the uncountables countable. So here is an activity for you. What is the instruction? Match the quantifying unit nouns in column A with their suitable nouns in column B. So here are two columns, column A and column B. There are some quantifying nouns in column A and some nouns, uncountable nouns in column B, and you have to match column A with their nouns, quantifying nouns with their nouns. So do the activity, do it, and after complete your activity, check your answer with this. So dear children, we came to know about uncountables which are we can't count, and if you want to make the uncountable countable, then you have to add some quantifying nouns. There are also some words which are ending in s, but they looks like plural, but actually they are uncountables, and they always go with singular verb forms. There was also an activity for you. Do that activity and check your answer with the answer which is given in the video. Okay, have a good day. Thank you.